The 2023 baby name report has been released, showing which names are on the rise and which are on the nose. Oliver and Charlotte have topped the boys and girls list, but overall, gender-neutral names like Charlie, Riley and Jordan are climbing the charts. Oh. The list compiled by McCrindle also shows which names have dropped off the hit list completely, with Indiana and Zoe both falling out of the top 100.
Here to offer her insight, comedian, oracle of everything, Mel Buttle!
Hello.
Welcome, Mel. You've recently become a mum, so that's right up your alley right now. How did you find choosing a name?
Listen, what I did was you have to really keep an eye on pregnant women, Waleed, because I'll say it loud and proud, they lose their mind. And you need someone there who can say, hey, let's not name the kid after the bloke who installed the blinds. Why don't we have a bit of a think? Because you've only had pickle juice for lunch, so let's, you know, keep a cool and calm head about it.
Right.
So what did you end up naming your son in the end?
Oh, well, the midwife said, are you going to call him Prince Harry because he's got red hair? And I said, yes, I am. And that's his name. And I don't back down from a double dare.
Yeah. I put a Harry too. Best name ever.
Oh, it's a great name. So it had nothing to do with his cute little face to know that Harry was the name for him.
Oh, they're not cute when they come out. Oh, rough as guts. And look, honestly, I wanted to get Bindi Irwin on the phone. I was like, do you want this up at the zoo, darling? This is a mess. What he looked like when he was born was a potato that someone had drawn an old man's face on. But honestly, I love motherhood. It's so great. Like 18% of the time, it's pretty good.
Well, Mel, I'm not a parent, but I've always thought there should be certain rules parents should have to follow when naming children. Do you agree?
I do agree. I think let's not be creative with our kids' names. Right. Let's be creative at paint and sip. Let's not put extra vowels in a name. You know, get your creativity out there. Don't just call your kid Callista Renee for fun. You know, there's got to be some rules, Sam.
So, well, you got a nice normal name. So that follows that rule. Did your parents flirt with any other options?
Oh, they did. Well, I was going to be called Cherie. Like Cherie's cuts and colour. That was until Dad stepped in and put his foot down and said, no, she's going to be Melinda, which I don't really like, to be honest. It's very 80s. It's just, I hear the name, it reminds me of French onion dip and West Coast coolers. Melinda, it's like a model of water filter that you would buy.
Yeah.
But the worst bit about being Melinda is I go by Mel, right? So, and then people go, oh, Melissa. And I go, no. Then they go, Melanie. And I go, no, worse. Keep going, way worse.
Hey, a few names have disappeared from the list this year. Do you think that's fair?
Look, in a big win for common sense, Indiana has gone. And that's huge because why would you name your kid after a crap American town? We've got crap towns here,
yeah.
You know? You can call your kid Bankstown or Tullamarine. Keep it Aussie. The name Karen also is completely off the list. It didn't even make the list at all, and I'm sure there will be complaints about that.
So if you're in charge, God help us, what names would be on the chopping block?
I'd like to get rid of Kristen, Kirsten, Christy and Kirsty. I think they're too similar. Mm. I think all those people can just be called Big K. What's up? Waleed, though, you're right. I would never, you know, your name does not need to be put through any name tribunal. You are unique and exotic, as my mum would say.
Oh, or are you just trying to avoid calling me Big W?
Mate, Big W, that suits you, actually.
Big Dub.
Is that a compliment?
I think it does. Yeah, you're a Big Dub.
It's better than K-Fart. Okay.
A moderately priced department store.
Thanks so much for sharing, though.
My pleasure. See you later.